Jin Lun Yang. I'm the National Ambassador for Young People's Literature. Thank you for watching this month's episode of the Reading Without Walls video podcast. I am here today with Ngozi Ukazu.
Perfect, yeah.
Thank you so much for joining me.
Yeah, don't worry.
So we, right now we are at the Emerald City Comic Con in Seattle. And you have been in the Artist Alley for the entire con. How's that been?
It's been great. They really focus a lot on the artistry, even though it's a big convention.
Yeah, yeah. So how did you get into making comics?
Oh man, I've made comics since I was a kid. I didn't even realize that I was, you know, putting words and pictures together ever since like elementary school. High school, I was like the comics editor.
You were the comics editor in high school?
That's awesome. I did like layout design and then comics editing.
That's great.
And yeah, in college I just kept on drawing.
Do you remember, was there a book or a creator that sparked your interest in that way?
I can't say, because I always was very interested in like animated series and sitcoms.
Okay.
I really liked storytelling in that aspect, and even now the comics that I do is still kind of very like simple camera like drama.
I see. Okay, so do you remember the animated shows?
Oh, like anything by Bruce Timm, I really love Justice League.
Really? Okay, so we're on the same level on that.
Yeah. But I was also watching like Ally McBeal and Frasier and like Martin and Everyone Loves Chris, and oh my gosh, The Simpsons was huge.
The stories you watch fed into the stories you know, right?
I think so.
What are you, what work are you talking about here?
Yeah, the comic that I mentioned that I work on is called Check Boots. It's the story of a figure skater who joins a college hockey team, and he likes to bake, so it's kind of quirky.
Okay.
I was born in Texas, and I don't know how to skate, but in college I really got into hockey. I did all this research to write a screenplay the senior year of my time in college. And then, I went to art school and I decided to keep making a comic, keep telling stories about hockey.
So this is a character that's been with you for a long time?
Well, as pretty much as soon as I started doing research, then this character kind of was born.
What parts of you do you think are going to this character? Like, there must be some overlap, right?
It's weird. I get that question a lot, and I feel like different parts of me go into different parts of the character, but the main character, his name is Mitty. I think he is... Well, one funny thing about him is that he, like, is really easily distracted. He loves to bake, and he loves to, like, skate and play hockey, but he loves his homework, and I feel like I can sometimes be that.
Okay. Oh, I gotta say, if you're here with a finished comic, You must be able to fade.
Maybe I don't have time manage, but it's like, I always say, like, I'm like never busy, I'm always procrastinating.
It takes a lot of effort to finish a comic, so you might procrastinate sometimes, but you definitely don't do it all the time.
Yeah.
What sort of comics are you reading nowadays?
Oh my gosh, well, I actually just finished Boxers.
Oh, thank you for that. I totally was not fishing for that.
That was a trip. Yeah, it was all planned. I read a lot of webcomics, and I've been into a lot of illustration, actually.
So give me a webcomic recommendation. I am totally behind on
this. Oh, okay, so I've got to totally plug my friend's webcomic. It's called Savannah.
Okay.
It's about two brothers who live and grew up in Japan, in Tokyo, and they work in the sushi fish market. And it's like this weird slice of life thing as they are like scared to talk to girls and dealing with mom and all this stuff.
That's awesome. That sounds great. Okay. Yeah, I just think there's so many good webcomics out there now. Sometimes for people who aren't familiar with that world, it's just hard to know. So thank you again so much for joining me on the
podcast. I appreciate it.
It's awesome. Thank you so much.